So gone over you, 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 no Monica, silly of me, devoted so much time to find you a faithful boy, and it lost my mind, drive at your house every night, in an unmarked car. Wonder what she had on me to make it break my heart. I just want to come on here and share my scent of the day because I am not going to the gym stinking, girl, and neither should you. I am testing out the Victor and Ross spice bomb today. I'm not putting on a lot because it's spicy, and I just want to see what it's giving. Just want to see what it's giving. Test run. That's it. I'll report back, all right? I hope y'all having a great Monday. Happy Monday. I'm sure I'm not going to have the same energy in about 30 minutes when I'm in the gym dying. But I got it now, and I'm going to give it to y'all. Y'all have a great day. Bye-bye.
Amazing, amazing.
Okay, so.
Under your regular skincare.
I just want to come on here and share my scent of the day because I am not going to the gym spanking, girl. And neither should you. I'm not putting on a lot because it's spicy, and I just want to see what it's giving. Just want to see what it's giving. Test run. That's it. I'll report back, all right? I hope y'all having a great Monday. Happy Monday. I'm sure I'm not going to have the same energy in about 30 minutes. Girl, and neither should you. I am testing out the Victor Ross. Okay, so I've been trying to tell myself to, like, be committed to doing something and stop halfway doing stuff. So my scent of the day is, I would take this in the car with me, but the Victor and Ross scents, they have this little click thing on it. Focus, focus, thank you. They have this little click thing on it that you click, and then that's how you can't spray it down. Normally, I would take my gym fragrance and my gym bag with me, but anyway, I got this in PR last week, which y'all don't know about because I wasn't vlogging last week, so y'all don't know. Y'all don't know, but this is Victor and Ross Spice Balm. This is their infrared, and it's real spicy, but I feel like it's going to hold up in the gym well, so we're going to give it a run. Now, it's real spicy on the front end, but I really think I like it. The dry down is really mellow, woody, and really sweet to me. The opening is very spicy, though. You're going to get that spice, but it is currently 4:25. I am supposed to be in my car by 4:30. I am on target to getting there. So yeah, got my Summer Fridays lip balm. I haven't told y'all about this, but this has been my favorite lip balm. This is the pink sugar one. I also like the vanilla one. I just bought a vanilla one and I already can't find it. But this has replaced all of my lip balms and replaced all of my friends' lip balms. Literally every friend I tell about this, they go and get it because of me. And they are obsessed. We are all obsessed. We are an obsessed union. I'm also taking my workout, my fan today to the gym because it'd be kind of hot. And if you guys can't, oh shit, that it was some dust in there. It got in my eye, girl. Oh my God. Oh, Jesus. If you guys can't tell, my face has been working out very, very badly. I think it's hormonal. I'm going to the doctor. I have a doctor's appointment Friday. Been trying to figure it out for the last few months. It's crazy trying to get a doctor up in Kaiser, but that's a story for another day, girl. But yeah, we're working on it. That's why I really haven't been on my social medias, really been active, because it's been very insecure about it, especially like somebody that on social media, I'm an ambassador for a skincare brand. People come to me with skincare concerns and questions. I've always been kind of like that skincare person. So for my face to be breaking out, girl, it's really been taking me down. But we're working on it. And I'm trying to tell myself that everything happens for a reason. Can't do nothing about it. Control what I can't control. I mean, focus on what I can't control. I can't control it. Why am I focusing so much energy and time into it? I do need to find my workout towels, though, because I've been trying to, like, be more cognizant about what I wash my face with, and I washed them, but I don't know where they are.
Now, I don't know how the girls drive and vlog, and I can't tell y'all that I'm about to figure that out. I'm not buying no mount. I think this is dark. I don't even think y'all can see me. I wonder if I can set my camera up here. Just check it out for sure. Maybe. No, maybe not. See, I mean, if I was gonna vlog, I would need to sit it up here. See, I need to like sit right here. Okay. Well, alrighty then, baby. Oh, Jesus. Yeah. This song is in my head, so when I hear a song in my head, I have to play it. Alright, let's head to the gym. Let's head to the girl. In the car. Ignore. I'm gonna call him back. Let's go to the gym, baby. Let's go to the gym. Yeah. Why?
Because that's what we gotta do.
Like a motherfucker.
Run where?
Where?
Why?
Figure it out. Okay.
The other option was to go run the hill, but it started raining. So either run the hill in the rain or do this.
Wait, what we about to do though?
The high knees.
How long?
The whole
like a normal class, we always do.
It's like 18.
What? Well, hell, I ain't doing Ross class then.
Ross not even coming.
Yeah, so I get my class and his class.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
That's what I said.
Ross not
I
coming
said,
in, so
I was going to say for Ross because I was. Peace out the hole on my time. I can't go there. If I see these fits to your bone, you can leave. All the psychopathies is learning all the streets.
Okay, y'all, I'm gonna have to figure out this car setup because I can't figure out where to like actually sit the camera. And you're behind my steering wheel right now, but that workout really kicked my ass. And I'm pooped. I have to go to the grocery store. I was gonna take you guys in the grocery store with me, but my camera is on 8%. I didn't get to charge it a lot before I left the house. So there's that. But workout went great. I burned almost right at 900 calories, 899 calories, over 1,000 active calories, which is really good for one workout for me. I usually stay on Mondays. I usually do, like I said, legs, cardio, and then yoga, but the cardio and yoga instructor couldn't make it today, so I only did one class. My lips are chapped as hell. I'm gonna sit here in the car and digest my protein. I have been using pure plant protein as of lately, the vanilla from Ripple Nutrition. This, hopefully you can see, it's focusing on me. Don't focus on me, focus on the product. But yeah, I'm not gonna say it's great, but it's the best plant protein that I've had. So it is what it is. I like to guzzle this down real quick and not think about it. Just so I can get my protein in. And yeah, I'm gonna go to the grocery store and get my groceries for the week. So I can cook. I think I'm gonna do salmon and green beans this week. Keep it simple. That's what I usually eat every week. It's nothing crazy. I don't know why it's having such a hard time. See, yeah, this car thing is gonna take me out. But that's it. That was my workout. We got that done, got some of that recorded for y'all. I'm gonna head to the grocery store, grab a few things, and I'll check back in when I get home and charge this battery, probably after I shower, and yeah, I'll see y'all later.
Specifically males, because you are so damn nice, and you do allow such a space for people to be themselves, but at the same token, it's like, when does Daniel say, bitch, no, because this isn't bringing me joy, this is filling my bucket. You being nice to these niggas is still filling their bucket, still allowing them to not feel how weird they are. You don't need to be here. I don't like you that much.
Okay.
Like, you're making me uncomfortable.
Okay.
So I don't need to be here. Like, I do not need to talk to you.
And okay. Okay, what's going on, y'all? I done got out of the shower. I decided that I wasn't going to go to the cleaners or the grocery store first because I really want to get to my esthetician appointment early because, like I said, I have to film some content. So I'm about to take... Earlier, I was telling y'all about the Focus Lemons, and these are the ones that I take. They're from Ollie. I have them linked in my storefront, but you can also get them from Target if you don't feel like waiting for them to ship. I take one every day, and when I tell you I cannot function if I don't, I can function if I have something to do, but like when I don't have anything to do, but I need to do things, one a day. Keep that bullshit away. I don't think you can cuss on YouTube like that. I'm gonna have to get me a little, I'm gonna put that little, from SpongeBob. So when y'all hear, just know I said a cuss word. Cause I ain't about to be cussing. But I'm about to get ready. I think I know what I'm wearing. But I just need to double check. So I know I didn't tell y'all, but my best friend moved into a brand new beautiful home, and I've been living with him because my place of residence, which we'll talk more about in detail with my life update, is not ready yet. It was supposed to be ready July, and it's still not ready. So I am currently staying with him. Thank God for friends, because I don't know what I would do. But I said all that to say that most of my stuff is still in his garage, including some of my clothes. So what I sometimes have to do, because I'm lazy, let me just hold this. I don't even think it's that I'm lazy. I just don't want to take the time to take the stuff from down here, putting it up there, because I'm going to be moving back out soon. And I just don't want to have to go through all that. So maybe that is lazy, but I'll be lazy. But I literally came down here for a shirt that I want to wear today. It's this really cute shirt from ASOS. I love this shirt. It's way too big, but I'm gonna try my best to make it work. The thing is though, it's too big, and it was too big like 2 months ago, and I think I've slimmed down a little bit since then, so it's probably gonna be even bigger. But here's the shirt. I just think it's so cute. Has a little flower on it. But I think I'm gonna do an oversized look with some tight jeans, and maybe that'll balance it out. This will kind of be the last of my little summer looks. I'm trying to hurry up and finish this. I need to get something recorded before I leave. So I need to hurry up and get dressed so that I can actually leave. I want to leave here by 10:30 because my appointment is at 12, and I want to get there around 11:30 so that I will have plenty of enough. That'll give me 30 minutes to film my content. So that's the goal. Leave here by 10:30. It's 9:53. I already showered. All I gotta do is do a get ready with me, which I'm gonna do that down here. I'm gonna do a get ready with me, just for my fragrance of the day. That's what I was supposed to do when I was down there. Talk about my fragrance of the day, but I think I'm gonna talk about the new YSL myself. I think I'm gonna wear that today so I can talk about it. And yeah, I'm gonna get out of here. Well, I'm trying to look. I might have to just stop and get me. I'm gonna take my water with me. The thing is, I have a lot of things that I wanna do today. I wanna leave the esthetician and go to the mall. I don't know if I told y'all or not, but I want some new I have some new balances, and I'm going to lunch tomorrow, so I really want to have something that I can wear tomorrow, like just like a t-shirt from like Walmart or something. I just wanna dress down for lunch tomorrow, cause I have some other errands that I want to run tomorrow. In prep for New York Fashion Week, I need to take some things to the tailors. Trying to cross compare because the tailors that I go to now is really expensive, so I'm gonna take some mock things that I really don't care about that much to another tailor and see how they do. And if they do well and get my stuff back to me quickly, I'll take my New York Fashion Week things to them. So we're gonna see how that goes. But I do want to make some stops, which means that I'm gonna be out for a vast majority of my day, which means that I am gonna need some snacks, because if I don't have snacks with me in the car, I will stop and get something that I should not eat. And I already have my dinner prepped and ready. So I think I'm gonna take, I don't understand why they be putting these tape on these bananas and you can't barely get it off. But I'm going to take a banana with me, and I'm gonna take this Sutra juice, this Vibrant Probiotic Purified Water, Strawberry, Raspberry, Lemon, and Honey. I never had this flavor before, but it sounded pretty good. This was $4. And I said, Miss Sutra. All right, girl, I hope it's worth it. But between this, my banana, and I just had a protein shake, let's just hope I make it back home, because I don't think I have anything else here that I can take. And I tried to see if the smoothie place I like was open, because I was going to go get a smoothie to add to this. And they didn't respond, so I don't know what's going on. But I'm going to take this with me and drink a whole bunch of water, and we're gonna see how it goes. I need to also go ahead and take my vitamins, but I'll do that shortly. All right, I'm gonna try to go get myself dressed and report back shortly. I'll call y'all back when I get dressed. All right, y'all, so I am dressed, and I literally just got done trying to film some content, and I filmed 2 videos, and I'm just looking at, my face is kind of inflamed right now, really red. And you can really see it a lot in the video, and I'm just trying to get to the, I'm really, as a creator, trying to get to the point that is struggling, as someone that is struggling with acne, really, really bad. I'm gonna sit down because I need to respond to this email before I leave. As someone who is struggling with acne really bad right now, in a season where I don't know why, it has really been challenging for me. Especially creating content, because I'm just a stickler about how certain content should look. Not saying that I can't put out content that doesn't look a certain way, but I'm just really picky about how my things look. And yeah, I'm just looking at these videos and I just don't like how, I don't like how it looks. So I don't know if I'll even be posting this content. I might have to just try to record the video, same video tomorrow, about this layering combo. I'm not gonna let it get me down though. I feel like usually it would get me down because I haven't tried to film anything in quite some time. But it is what it is. I am about to go get a facial, so hopefully when I leave there, I might just leave there and come home and film some content, because my face usually looks good after my facial. But I just got an email back from the jet which is a DC public transportation. I want to see if I can get them to let me travel with them for New York Fashion Week so that I can cut down on some of my expenses. So I need to stop what I'm doing. And when I get inquiries or anything like this, I always stop immediately and send the email back because I just want to make sure they know I'm like very interested. So I always stop what I'm doing to respond to an email. The good thing about the YSL myself, which is what I have on today, which is what I was trying to film a video about, it's one of my favorites. I'll show you how to bottle. Okay, so this is the bottle. Very pretty, very pretty. This is my like favorite scent. I bought it about 3 weeks ago from Macy's. This size was $89, so you can't really tell because of where the bottle is, but it's already down to here and I've only had it for like 2 weeks, so I'm already gonna need a new bottle. But luckily, God is good. I'm not a content creator that constantly talks about fragrances, but I guess when I do, people pay attention, because I always end up on the right people's PR list. So YSL actually sent me an email last week and they're going to send me the PR package that I've seen everybody else get. So I'm very excited about that. So that's why I want to go ahead and do a video about it now, because I don't want to make it. I can just do another video talking about it and then do another. As a content creator, you try to strategize your post. And I guess it would be kind of cool to show the PR box after I've already been a user of the fragrance. I just kind of wanted to go ahead and show that I have already been using it. But I guess it really doesn't matter, because I already have the bottle and there will be a significant dent in it. But anyway, this is the scent I'm wearing today. It's a fresh, woody, but floral scent. I think it's something that men and women could wear. I'm curious to see what women will be. I want to see the women that love masculine scents like give this a run and see what they think about it. So I'm ready for a woman to actually smell this. This is a good brunch scent. This is a good winter scent, fall scent. I think it's an all year round scent. I definitely feel like this is one of YSL's best fragrances. As a fan of most of their scents, I have a few of their scents actually. This is the best one, I think, because for me, I love to wear fragrances that are good for men and good for women. I don't put me in a box in any way, shape, form, or fashion. So I'm very excited about this scent and I'm gonna respond to this email and get out of here because it's almost 11 and I have to be there by 12 and I'm clearly not gonna be there early. So yeah, but we're gonna get there. All right, I'll check back in with y'all at some point. Bye.
The only thing you even have a point of reference for is good and God. But if you eat from this tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you're gonna have knowledge of something that I never wanted you to know. The knowledge of good and evil wasn't necessarily just the knowledge of good, but it is the reality that when you have the knowledge of good and evil, it can be difficult to distinguish between the two. Talk for a minute about the knowledge of evil that God never intended for you to know. To that, I think he sat back and waited long enough to see that what I thought was an evil affliction was actually God making all things work together for my good. It takes someone crazy to look at what the enemy meant for evil and say,
Baltimore, that wasn't a bad drive. I feel like the more I drive it, the easier or the faster I feel like I get here. But yeah, I am here. I'm gonna turn my camera on for a second. I feel like my camera is gonna get hot or cut off. So yeah, but as y'all know, I cannot set my camera up in the car. But I was listening to a Sarah Jackson sermon And baby, it was giving me all my life. And I actually am not late. Like, I was actually here on time. I just had to send an email in the car. Hi, good, how are you? Oh, I'm tired.
You want any water or anything?
No, thank you, I'm fine.
Hi.
Hi, you ready?
Yeah.
Oh, I was so about to sit down, I'm tired.
Oh.
I think I'm gonna do this stuff after.
All right, you're just gonna film around here?
Yeah.
Okay.
You wanna say hi to the wall?
No.
She be acting shy, y'all. We gonna get there.
Do you need
the
restroom?
Yes.
Sorry, you can put your stuff down.
Oh, Jesus. So much equipment, Lord.
I know, and my room is tiny, too.
Woo, baby, that mama you be waiting on the air. Come on, Jesus! Come on, Jesus! Okay, ooh. I swear. This skin shit has been the most emotional journey that I have ever endured in my entire life. Got a facial. Me and my esthetician both are noticing that things are changing with my skin. My doctor wanted me to add in some type of benzoyl peroxide somewhere in my routine. So that's what I've been doing on top of my face reality routine. And so we're getting better. We're not where we were, but we're getting better. Not the best, but better. Less and less pustules, which is great, because usually I will wake up every morning with like 15 to 30 white pustules all over my face. So that's no longer. That has kind of died down a bit, and yeah, I'm a little red from the benzoyl peroxide, but that's not abnormal. So we're just gonna keep monitoring. I'm gonna keep doing what I'm doing at home. And yeah, that I'm doing all I can do. I do have a doctor's appointment this Friday, and then I have a dermatology appointment on the 15th. I've been waiting to get into dermatology since July. It's quite insane. But that's a story for another day. But I literally, like, I can't tell you how much pain I was in, like, during the extractions. And it's crazy because this side of my face is what I perceive to be the worst. But she said I have a lot of scar tissue over here, which is a good thing because it means this side of my face is healing. I had a lot of active acne over here, which is why she had to spend so much time over here. My forehead is getting much better. I have something going on right here. And this area is always going to be a problem for me, my chin. But we're making progress. And that's what I call a journey. A journey is making progress, even if the progress seems slow. So I'm thankful. Thankful for the little progress that I've been making, and I'm grateful for where I am because I'm a few steps, just a few short steps ahead of where I was, and for that I'm grateful. I'm gonna crack open my banana and head to the mall and see what I can see. Yeah, get back on my side of town because traffic is about to be crazy me getting back home, so I'm about to hit it. All right, y'all, I'll call y'all back. Okay, I'm finally at the mall. I feel like I've been running and running and running and running, but I really haven't. I had got to the mall, and then I realized, because y'all know I still ain't ate no full meal today, I realized that I was hungry, so I found a Smoothie King that was like 6 minutes away. I don't know what all this. Sorry, somebody was calling me. I don't know what all this is in here. I can't even remember. But I do know I got some plant protein added to it to fill me up. And I still have my banana left. I might get me a little snack, random snack out the mall or something. To hold me over until I get home. And that way, when I get home, I can literally just take a shower, relax for the rest of the day. I'm going in the mall. I'm not taking y'all in the mall because I just need to be in and out. So, yeah. I just wanted to update this. Because I don't know how long this vlog is going to be, but it's feeling like it's long. And I don't want it to be more than 45 minutes. And I still haven't did my life update. So y'all might have to wait on that. I don't know. We're going to see because I end up doing more this week than I intended. But we're going to see. I just want to check in. I'm going in the mall. If I see anything spectacular or something that I just want to share, I will pull out my phone and do so. All right, girl. All right. Good morning, good morning, good morning. It's morning. Now it's time for us to say goodbye. Goodbye, baby. Good morning. It would be crazy if my best friend just so happened to not be at work and I'm screaming. But anyway, it's Thursday. I did not pick my camera up yesterday because I went out for happy hour and I really didn't record because we was just really talking. But you ain't missing nothing. It wasn't nothing crazy food, no crazy deal. I just went out to the water at Alexandria, then went and got some hookah. Real chill. Trying to really save all my gas for this weekend because it's Labor Day weekend. And I'm trying to really decide, hold on, because I found my older tripod for my camera that I had. And now I remember why I did not like this, because it is hard to get it to sit. Hold on, y'all. Okay, that is much better. Because my other tripod, it wouldn't lift. And girl, I need you to lift. Nigga, Lee said, but I need you to lift. So I won't have to be bending on the camera. So I found my old tripod. So I guess I don't really like it, but it'll hold for now. I think as a content creator, once you actually start doing something, you realize like, that may not be the best thing. But it is Thursday. It is 12:23. I have to be at the gym by 5:00. I need to be leaving here by 4:00. I want to eat breakfast. And I also want to, I need to edit a video, at least put it together today. And I'll do the voiceover tonight after I get home from the gym. I need to go to the grocery store because I don't have dinner for the night. And what else do I need to do? I want to see, it depends on what all I end up getting done, what my day really consists of, but I know that I need to put that video together, and I know that I have to eat breakfast. I'm washing clothes right now, so Thursday is like my maintenance day, where I kind of wash my hair, clean. I try to go ahead and like do my laundry for the week because I go to the gym and all the gym clothes have accumulated. I don't like to let them sit in the bin too long and sweat. But I need to do, I still have not did that unboxing, y'all. And I'm not doing it today because I generally don't create content on like Wednesdays or Thursdays because my haircut is on the end of its leg. And I just, y'all know how I am. So I'll probably wait and do that video tomorrow. But it's something in there that I want to use, so I kind of want to like open it and then use it and then like record it later. I might just record like a standard unboxing on my phone and then do like a TikTok where I sit down and actually talk about what's in the box. So maybe two separate videos that may work best for me because it's a hydrator, not a Super Ativa brand, and they sent me soaps for my body, but they also sent like an undergarment wash. I think they sent that to me. And I wanna wash like my tank tops in it because that is what actually like touches my skin. And like, I'm wondering if it's gonna help with this acne that I have on my chest and on my back. Just because it's a really gentle cleanser, I'm sure. But I'm about to cook and watch All the Queen's Men. And Yeah, I'm cooking the same thing I ate the other day. Standard eggs, spinach with a little bacon. I think I'm going to put my bacon in the oven today, though, because while the microwave bacon was okay, I need that crisp. So, I'll check in with y'all at some point. I may record myself cooking. I don't know yet. We're gonna see. But it's Thursday. It's almost Friday. Y'all, I really had told myself that I was going to start. I really was supposed to start my vlogs on Friday for the new week, and they go from Friday to Friday. Just because Friday, I'm actually like, that's the day I usually, I don't drive to DC often, but when I do go to DC, like tomorrow when I go, I want to see if I can take my shoes to get them deep clean. A pair of my loafers, which I need to call them today and see how long they actually keep the shoes, because I need them back by next Wednesday. But I want to get those cleaned. I need to take some things to the tailors, y'all. None of my stuff, only one jacket and a pair of glasses has came for Fashion Week, and that's it. And I'm not even tripping about it, to be honest. Like, it is what it is. I'm focusing on things that I can't control. And if I have to pull some old stuff out of my closet, I'm gonna just have to pull some old stuff out of my closet and make it work. But yeah. I don't want to end the vlog on Friday. I feel like that's a good day to start it. But it's also like so much that I didn't. I feel like I have enough vlog content for the week though, just to like kind of get my feet wet, get myself back out there. I don't necessarily. The thing I always said about vlogs and why I didn't do them is because some weeks I just don't do much outside of going to the gym. But I think this is a good starter to get my wheels back going. And then next Friday, I will film from Friday. That vlog will be from Friday until Wednesday. And that will be like New York Fashion Week prep, all that kind of stuff. And then New York Fashion Week, while I'm there, is going to have its entire separate vlog. Up until, because I'll be there from Thursday to Monday, and then I'll probably start another vlog that Monday. So I'm trying to really get on the schedule. This makes me feel like I have something to do, which is what I said I wanted to do, because I'm not a get ready with me content kind of person, at least not yet. If I do start doing that, it will be only on TikTok. I don't want to put that on Instagram, but I have on pajamas right now. And I'm also very particular about my clothes. I don't want to just be putting stuff on just to put something on just for recording the video. If it's crisp and came from the dry cleaners, I want it to stay crisp until I wear it. But that's some things I have to work out within myself. But anyway, at this point, I'm just rambling. My focus dummy has not kicked in yet, but I have taken it. I'm about to start cooking so that I can have eaten by one. I don't like eating too close to the time I'm going to the gym, because I do not want to throw up. And he got us running heels today. I took yesterday off, like I said, because we're about to do trying to do no days off September, which I don't know how that's gonna work, because I don't know if the place I'm going to has a gym. I need to look that up. I'm gonna cook now because I'm rambling, and yeah, we'll see where the day goes.
Exactly. Look, man, when y'all just stop with this girl shit, we got bigger shit to worry about.
All right, y'all.
Matt, I want to talk to him.
He got it. I just made some eggs. And this is the eggs. I am going to now make, I decided I'm gonna make a wrap. I usually don't eat really, really, this is my heavy breakfast meal, but I haven't eaten. And I'm kind of really hungry. So I'm gonna take, I love using these Mission Carb Balance wraps. They're 70 calories, 3.5 grams of fat, 18 grams of carbs, 15 dietary fibers, which is really like 3 grams of carbs if you like on like a ketosis thing, and 5 grams of protein. I like using these when I know that I did 2 eggs and some egg whites today, and 4 strips of bacon. So this is a pretty heavy meal, but that means my meal tonight probably won't be as heavy. I don't know what I'm eating yet. I'm probably gonna stop and get like some salmon and green beans or whatever. But I like to take these little carb wraps. I put them on a napkin or a plate. in the microwave. And then I take, I've been cutting back on dairy, so I use this BioLife 100% vegan Mexican style cheese strip. And I just spread probably like a little handful on the wrap. And I make me like a little breakfast burrito-ish type thing. That's a lot of cheese. And the reason that I go ahead and put this in the microwave with my tortilla is because this cheese takes a long time to melt or get hot, but it also doesn't taste the best to me when it's super, super melted. So I leave that in there for about probably 30 seconds, a little under 30 seconds. And then I go ahead and just put my eggs in there and make me a little wrap, and yeah. But my show's still going, so I just had to kind of tell y'all that right quick. And I'm about to chop down. Oh, I'm so hungry. So this is what it looked like. Give it a little milk. And I'm not gonna put all my eggs in there. Just gonna do like half and actually eat the other half regularly. But then I just fold it together. And I used to work at Taco Bell, baby, so my burritos be burritoing. Look at that. Look at that burrito. Ah, 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 ooh, ah, 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 ah. Okay, back to my show. I'm done. Oh, my little food looks so good, y'all. Look at that. Got my wrap, my bacon, and my eggs and spinach. Period, pool. Snatch September is on the way. Period. Oh, let me say my prayers. Yeah. God, thank you for this food. May it be nourishment to my body. God, thank you for this day. Thank you for walking with me, talking with me, stepping in places before me, stepping in rooms before me, preparing tables for me. In Jesus' name, God, we just thank you for an amazing day. We thank you for where we are, because where we are is not where we have been. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. All right, I'm about to eat. Y'all been with me all morning. Feel like it's 1:30, and I need to be leaving the house by 4:00 because I gotta stop and get some pre-workouts. And yeah, that basically means I have an hour to edit my video. So yeah, probably gonna edit it while I sit here. So I'll check in with y'all when I get dressed for the gym. Bye.
In between, no, I'm either an angel or the devil. I have no fear. So, how about we just see, you know, who lives? It's a blank.
I will kill him.
Okay. Kill him. Put your fucking hand down. Now, you're doing a lot of talking. And if you say another word, this motherfucker will go off. Now, kid me the Felix thing. Tommy, get his hand. Get his hand. Hold it straight. Like, get his hand. Get his fucking hand.
Hold it straight. Like, get his hand. Get his fucking hand.
Don't fuck with Adam! Don't fuck with Adam! They thought she give a fuck about what the fuck y'all thought. Baby. Oh, I love that show. The Fashion Week packages are rolling in! And I think this is a bag that I have been. I'm so excited to see this bag. It's a Ghani bag. I think it's Ghani. And my stuff from ASOS came in. So we're just gonna do a little unboxing. I'm gonna actually record the unboxing of the bag for my TikTok. And I decided that I'm gonna go ahead and, this is gonna be the last day for this vlog. Yeah, this is gonna be the last day for this vlog because I think it's getting pretty long. I also need to, I'm supposed to be ordering. I gotta start getting dressed because I really hope my trainer does not have us running up the hill at 3 o'clock in the evening. Like, he had the people running up the hill this morning. And I do not feel like doing that. It's too hot. I hate working out outside. Like, what? Oh! Oh my god, it's so cute! Oh my god! Oh, I'm gagging. Gagging. Oh, I love a unique bag. Oh my god. I'm gagging. Oh, the girls are gonna eat this up. And the gag is I have not seen anybody with this bag. This, I got this bag for $165 off Essence. It's so cute.
Oh my god, it lays
for a lot
too.
That is so cute. So cute. Good morning. Y'all gonna have to be down here because I am currently driving. Hold on. Oh, I forgot I can extend this up a little bit. Let's do this and let's do. This is, I don't know if this is technically like considered dangerous because I always like drive with one hand on the wheel anyway, but we gonna see. I wanted to go ahead and get a start because I don't know that when I get into the house I'm gonna have any time to tell you guys what I have to do. My camera is probably gonna wobble a little bit, but you know, we still getting used to the vlogging thing around here. Y'all gonna have to give me some grace a little bit because I got a lot of stuff to do, and I done already told myself I need to charge my backup battery and everything so that I can be on one accord with y'all today. So I am trying, work with me. But no, I had to get up and go ahead and work out even though I did not have a lot of sleep. My lips are extremely chapped. Some of that pea protein that makes my lips chapped. But anyway, nevertheless, got my workout done. It is currently 6:25. I have a nail appointment at 10 o'clock. I have to take some clothes to the dry cleaners. And I'm trying to decide now if I want to go ahead and drop those off now. then go home, or if I want to go home, shower, and drop those off when I get ready to head out. I'm not quite sure yet. But anyway, I have to take some clothes to the dry cleaner so that I can pick them back up by today. If they're in by 9, I get them back by 5. That's why I love Zips. I wouldn't recommend like taking something that's super expensive there. But for like the basics, like my pants and stuff, I always take anything I'm taking out of town, I always take it to the tailors. I always take it to the dry cleaners first. Did I say tailors the first time, or did I say dry cleaners? Anyway, girl. But yeah, that's what I have to do. Then I have a nail appointment at 10. Then I have to go pick up my altered stuff in hopes that I realized that I never took, I have these jean cargo-like pants that I got from Fashion Nova that I really want to take to Fashion Week. I'm trying to do like this really cute look that I have in my head. Cause I really want to wear something spunky to like Essence. I don't want to, my theme for Fashion Week is like suits, but I don't really want to wear something like too classy to Essence. I want that to be my fun outfit. And so I have this white tank top that's kind of like, I don't know, I feel like anything that kind of like fits my body like really tight as a fat black man, I feel like it's always pushing it just a little bit. So I really want to wear, especially since it's gonna be hot this weekend, I really want to wear something like fun to Essence. So I want to get those jeans taken up so that I can wear this outfit that I have in mind with some old shoes that I'm bringing back out. I have these really cute shoes that I actually wore my first time. Let me see if I can find a picture while I'm at this red light. I actually wore them for the first time when I went to New York Fashion Week. I went up there for an event. I didn't actually like go to anything for real. But anyway, I have a cute outfit that I want to wear with that. So I really hope that these are the shoes. Focus. Yeah, but yeah, those are the shoes. And I really want to bring those back because I don't wear them that often anymore. And I think that would be super cute, especially with that that bag that I have. But yeah, I feel like it shouldn't take long. I'll go to the tailors often, and it's just really just like cutting something and taking it up. I don't want them, you don't gotta taper them. I just want you to cut them off and seal the hem up. That's all I need them to do. So cross our fingers that they do that for me. Do that for the doll. Ooh, excuse me. I have to get my eyebrows done, and I have to do a major Target. I have to run to Target, and I have to run into the mall. I need, like, for one of my looks, I need like it's a vested look, but I want to have like, instead of like a black tank top under, because I think you're gonna be able to see the tank top, I want a like a nude or brown tank top to go under it. So I need to go in like a rainbow or something and see if I can find me a tank top. And I need to go in Target because I just need essentials like soaps, body oils, things like that. You know, last minute stuff that you get for travel. And then I think that's all the stuff I have to do, but I also have to come home and pack. And I have to thoroughly pack tonight. I have not been doing a great job of packing before. I have been waking up the morning of and packing for trips, and I cannot risk that for New York Fashion Week, because all the things that I know I have to pack, and I have to be at my barber by 8:30, which means I need to probably be calling my Uber by 7:45, which means I need to be up by 6 o'clock, which means I'm not gonna have time to pack anything in the morning. I need to be just focused on getting ready, because as soon as I leave the barbershop, I have to go to get on the bus. Okay, y'all, I was trying to come check in with y'all. It is currently, hold on, I'm on mute. It is currently 11:16, And I just realized something was on my shoe. I've started like packing like one side of my bag because the other side of my bag is like usually clothes and stuff. And so I have to pack for New York Fashion Week a little bit differently. First of all, got home a few hours ago and ate. And what else did I do? Oh, I had to go to Target. I had a lot to do. I don't even remember last time I saw y'all. But I think I was putting in a Target order online. No. When I last saw y'all, I think I was going to Target. And got to Target. They didn't have everything I needed. Had to go. I put in an order at another Target. They showed that it was in stock. So I just did it as like a pickup order. And girl, while I got there and they didn't have the main thing that I wanted, which was, I don't even know where it is. The Aveeno body oil that I love, they didn't have it. And I just need, you know how you going somewhere and you just need your things, like you need everything you got at home? That's how I am when I travel. So I don't want no loose ends, like I need all my stuff. So I had to go, I left that Target, I had to go get my eyebrows done. All this is on everything is on two totally different sides of town. But anyway, I got home after doing all that. And yeah, I just been packing. I got all my accessories like over here. Oh, hold on. So those are all the colognes I'm taking. And these are all the colognes I'm, hold on. So I'm taking Commodity Gold, cause it's just a good thing to have. I'm taking Jo Malone, Wood Sage and Sea Salt. Sorry, I'm leaning in a very weird way. And so this is gonna be odd, but hold on, let me see if this is good. Okay, I think this is a, y'all just gonna have to excuse the mess in my room because it's fashion week, so I'm getting ready out of one room. But I do want to show y'all what I'm taking. I'm taking a fragrance that I haven't talked about online yet, and I haven't seen anybody else talk about it online. It is by Simone Andreoli. It's called Silenzio. When I tell you, every time I wear this, I always get compliments. It's like magic in a bottle. It's like kind of spicy, but also really sexy and sweet. Kind of smell like the color, I don't know, like if you put the color purple and made it real sexy in a bottle, that's what it smells like. I know that's a crazy ass description, but yeah, I always get compliments with it. I am taking Valentino Born in Roma Intense. This is the women's version, of course. These two layered together, 10 out of 10. Fragrance body oil from the Oil Bar. I got this while I was in Atlanta. It smells like Tom Ford Bitter Peach. This is also something you can just put on like running errands. Want to spice up a scent, add you a little peach to it. That's a good thing. Sorry y'all, I'm talking low, but Josh's room is not far from mine, so I can't be on team. But I did want to talk to y'all about this stuff because I'm not talking about all this when I get to New York. This also is kind of helping me know what I have and what I don't have. This one, I forgot what this smells like, bond number 9 something, but it smells good. 10 out of 10. So that's all I'm taking scent wise. I'm probably gonna try to buy a scent while I'm there though, because I feel like this fashion week is gonna be big for me. But that's all I'm taking scent wise and I got my shoes here. Taking black and white pair, gotta have a standard shoe, pop a color shoe. Good black shoe, something different, still kind of classy like the black and white shoe that I have. Got a popping shoe, nobody has these, have not seen those in years, so that is always going to be, when I wear those, it's always a standout. So, I didn't wear those last year for Fashion Week, so we're bringing them back out. And you can't go wrong with the Santa Pass JW Andersons. I can literally put these probably with anything that I have on that bed. And it's a good shoe and it's comfy. I'm really going to utilize the fact that it is hot this Fashion Week. And I have my, what's the name of this bag? Forgotten the name of this bag, but I carry it all the time. I carry it as like a little poof. I think this week I'm going to carry it like this tomorrow, like a little poof. These shoes and a blue suit, which y'all will see in the vlog, how I style everything. This bag I got from Zara, reminds me of kettlebell. It's a good conversation starter. What else do I have? I'm contemplating if I'm taking my Gucci bag. I just feel like I don't have anything. I'm trying to tell myself, if you don't have an outfit to go with it, you don't need to take it, girl. But this bag, she's the star of the show. She's the star of Hove in the entire Fashion Week. I just feel like nobody's going to have this bag. I have not seen anybody talk about this bag, which is why I haven't posted it yet. I didn't want nobody to go snatch it up. But this bag is so perfect. As my girl Janae will say, are you dying? Are you fucking dying? What? Is this bag not the cutest? It's sporty. It's made out of like that little nylon like material, but I'm pairing it with something really classy because I feel like it doesn't look like a sporty bag. It looks like it can go both ways. I had to have it, and I got it on the steel. I got it for like $165. And I think that's really the only thing new that I bought for Fashion Week. I'm trying to save some money. I'll show you the shades I'm bringing. Taking the Loewe vase that I got last year for Fashion Week that I never wear. Okay. I'm leaning on one hand, so I'm having to do everything with one hand. It is not going well. My products, purple products that I always have. I don't know if you can really see the detail on them because of the way I'm sitting, but yeah. I hope y'all can hear me, because I know I'm talking low. These little Amazon glasses that I got, I feel like these are good. Throw on. Old but faithful. Never going over without these. Literally bury me in those glasses immediately. And these new babies that I got. These are some Tom Ford like blue light glasses. I don't think they're like really glasses, but I think they're so cute. I love the tint to them. I love how it looks like kind of iridescent. I might wear these tomorrow. Go ahead and I have one show to go to tomorrow with my friend Kayla. I feel like I might as well just shit. It hurt. I don't know. I feel like I might as well just pop out and come on with it. I also got my package from Bruce Glenn. Now, I don't know if I'm still going to wear this just because it is a jacket and it is hot. New York right now, and I don't know, but I did want to unbox it on camera. Probably not gonna try it on. I don't feel like going through all of it, but I was super excited about this jacket. I was actually supposed to go to this show, but it's next week and I will be back home, so I'm not gonna make it. But I do need an RSVP for this like street style show. And I think I may. Let me do this. Ah. this to Essence. Oh, shut up. Oh, shut up. I hope this can fit. I got a 3X. I wonder if I should have got a 4. Shut up. Oh, I might have to thug it out. I might have to thug it out. This is gore. Jeez, I actually think I could pull that bag with this too. And I don't even plan to do that. See, and I feel like I need to go somewhere popping to pull this out. Definitely could have sized up, but I like this because I know jackets are going to get kind of loose. What? Bruce Glenn, please. Bruce Glenn, please. I would have went up one more size. It would have been perfect. But I'm also not mad at how this fits. Like, with a baggy bottom. Oh. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna have to rethink because I was literally gonna save that for homecoming because I had a cute outfit that I wanted to wear the Essence, but I don't know. I'm gonna have to wear that Essence because I want to stand out. I don't know. But anyway, y'all, I am about to continue to pack. And yeah, I said I was gonna be done by 12 o'clock. That's clearly not true, but I'm not too far off because I got all my accessories except for one pair of glasses. And yeah. I really want to sit down and take a little break anyway. So, let me get back to it. I'll hit y'all later. I'll get ready to lay down.